Not like Ray and...
Yeah, no, well, well...
Star Wars name?
Oh, hi. Charlie and Copper.
Who's Steve Sansweet?
I, you know, some fuzzy guy who has lots of stuff.
Casa Kenobi.
Back here and show you a couple things.
This is Stu.
Stu is part of the home team.
He
is
Rancho OBI-WAN. I'm going to go egg collecting in my chicken farm.
All right. And we're heading towards the chickens now. And we are in Petaluma.
Hi, girls.
And we're in Petaluma on Butter and Egg Day.
Yes.
Did we get in okay?
Yeah.
All right, cool.
We saw some of the parade on the way up. There they go. Cool, Princess Leia. There's Han Solo.
Exactly.
Luke Skywalker. Come on, don't be greedy.
Yeah, I think they have
non-Star Wars.
They have non-Star
Wars.
There's no Leia. There's no Ahsoka.
R2BBQ?
R2BBQ.
R2BBQ, okay.
Yes, and Anne does enough smoking that a second one was warranted.
Yeah.
So... anyone like a sniff before I close it up?
I can start smell it from here. Oh,
actually.
R5D4, Dagobah, Rebel Scum, R2DT.
Barbecue Ewok.
Barbecue Ewok is my favorite.
You know, we're going to be doing a little bit of weird wandering in this corner. I know it sounds strange, it'll make sense in about a minute.
Stretch out with your feelings, but not with your hands. Or you may end up like that poor soul I had to deal with in the Mos Eisley Cantina. Rancho OBI-WAN is... OBI-WAN. OBI-WAN. If you're lucky, you also won't give into a spending spree, even at the Rancho OBI-WAN gift shop. Then again, in my experience, there's no such thing as luck. So pay attention to all instructions, follow your guide, and you will experience a galactic physical and spiritual reawakening.
So, do want to point out, Great Pit of Carcoon is the restroom. Now, pointing that out for two reasons. One, it's the restroom. You have a question about something, we'll try and answer it. What we don't know, we'll try and remember to ask Steve. Maybe we'll make something up. Oh, do you know the answer to the question, someone else? Please feel free to throw in the information.
Museum or somebody actively on eBay trying to hunt stuff down, like, how are additions made?
Replicas.
Not as much as when he was working at Lucasfilm. Mm-hmm. But still stuff comes in.
Can you check them out to read?
No, this is not a lending library.
Of course it's not that kind of library.
The one wasn't. I think when I was at the Star Wars Celebration, I bought either as part of my package, whatever. I was Jedi Master, or whatever.
So oh, right on. Oh, very cool. That's awesome. Yeah, I think my sister gave me a copy of the vault, which actually I used as part of my practice for learning tours. Because there are enough items in there that show up in the collection.
Yes, I found this book.
Lovely guests of Rancho OBI-WAN. Please feel welcome in the chocolate room.
Oh, wow.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my god!
I told you!
Wow.
Please watch your step. Don't go too far.
I'm gonna take a picture from up here.
Please do! Take a picture, film it, take two pictures. Just watch your step, please.
Don't fall.
Wait till they get down.
If you do fall, touch your chin to your chest.
What do you think, Tina? Oh my god, everything's here. Boba, Han, Chewbacca, Cantina, Darth Vader, action figures. Oh my god.
And this is all glued together acrylic, which means I can't get in to fix anything. So in order to scratch the frustrating itch in my brain, I started the game of, okay, well, because I can't go in to fix, we'll play the game of, please find the area where you want to say, go home, Stormtrooper, you're drunk. Or if there are small kids in the group, go home, Stormtrooper, you're sleepy.
Did you say those were film-worn Stormtrooper boots?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice.
Pardon me?
Steve's grown his collection.
They're really just a pair of boots.
Yeah.
Painted
just,
white.
They're just black boots painted white. Stormtrooper boots.
I want to know what the brand is.
And production used...
I'm trying to see if...
I don't know where Steve is getting this stuff, but this is a production used mold for Darth Vader's cowl.
So the Vader mannequin is a mishmash of different things. We will ignore the winter motorcycle gloves and the high-tech lightsaber. So the inner cape, inner suit, top bottom, and the cod piece.
They're all leather.
They're, well, yes, because the British costumers who had to fit them on David Prowse made them out of leather.
Ooh, this is film used, huh?
So these are film used. They have the costumers tag on the inside. The outer cape, the armor bits, including chest box, belt, and shin guards, were part of an ILM appearance costume. They had some tall dude they sent out to important things like Burger King events. And the helmet was, our research showed that it was probably built during Empire, but screen used during Jedi, and was the base for the Don Post Deluxe Vader helmets. Yeah. And then Don Post Jr. and team, bless their hearts, noticed it was looking a little scruffy and gave it a really nice shiny paint job.
Yeah. I mean, it took off all the screen used paint. And then, So
that was the blaster that they put together for the photo test. Behind it is the photo of that photo test.
Very cool.
Yeah.
And these are all the original from the 76.
So Steve was on set for that, and since Liam Neeson's contract, I guess, forbade him from being set on fire, they used a high temp wax dummy. Whatever.
What? Anyways, sissy.
But they did use one of his costumes. So Steve was on set for that. They run the scene, call cut, stagehands come and extinguish the flames. But, you know, a bunch of folks are released, head one direction, Steve waits. Part of the crew goes to undress the dummy, take it outside. Steve waits and then follows where they went. Eventually finds this wet brown pile of Lord knows what on the ground, goes to pick it up. What doesn't completely disintegrate, he keeps in his hand, and then realizes he has no place to put this damp pile of rag stuff, so he just kind of shoves it into his jeans pocket. Other than that, in terms of screen use stuff, we have a piece of Kajimi? Is that the planet they blew up in one of the recent films? And then a lot of the stuff, like the battle droid bits and the piece and the C-3POI and the supposed interior of a stormtrooper blaster rifle,
yeah,
those are all for the DKI visual dictionaries. But so moving over to this case, of course, we talked about the Duros earlier. These are from the original molds, the Duros and the Gibbon. Those are a pair of untrimmed Duros hands. The bottom shelf has some bits from the Sarlacc pit in Yuma. It has a ball cap, kind of ball cap with earmuffs, that Carrie Fisher was supposed to wear at a press junket in Hong Kong that she just bailed on. Yeah, chef's kiss, Carrie Fisher. And then in front of that are some pieces of Carrie Fisher's Endor costume. And for those with eagle eyes may notice that it says Leia number 3 on them. And that's just because it's just cheaper to make multiples of a costume piece than to make a film crew wait while you fix something.
Right.
Yeah. And then the middle shelf on the far left is a reverse power flux coupling cover. So for Jedi, they only assembled as much of the Falcon as they needed for shooting whatever they wanted to shoot. And then there was no plan to do more movies. There was no plan to save it. So they just junked it. And then Anthony Daniels, feeling very enterprising, walked through the rubble, picked up 10 random pieces, put them in acrylic cases, and then sold them at ridiculous prices to nutjob collectors. But Steve can say he owns a piece of the original Falcon, which is more than groovy. Then on the right side, we got a couple 3PO hands, one screen used, one not. And then you notice the black palm. In order for Anthony Daniels to close his hands, they had to shoot the palm with a heat gun. But even when they come out of that control room in the Death Star and C-3PO picks up the comlink, they had to use a combination of heat gun and movie magic, also known as double-backed gaff tape. Because even though they softened it up so he could close it, he couldn't close it enough to pick up that little prop. Mm-hmm. So they put some double back tape on his hand, and that's what picked it up off the counter. Mm-hmm. And the cherry on the sundae, four alarms crotch. That is the part of the costume from the film. Yes, sir.
No, sorry. Are you finished? I don't want to interrupt you. All
right. Other areas of the world probably shouldn't have tried to paint their bootlegs. And then we can talk about one of the more storied companies for bootlegs. That would be the Uze out of Turkey.
Yeah.
With their Stars War.
Stars War. Stars War.
I am
Stars War.
Exceedingly certain that Stars War has not pricked up any IP attorney's ears. Right. Anyway, so we have the Imperial Gunner operating the most dangerous weapon in the galaxy, an upside down, apparently, Casio calculator.
Yeah, he's playing a calculator. Okay, that's a good one.
Yep. And of course, the Blue Stars. Now, I'm sure we all remember that that tense moment as the Blue Stars and their frightening blue armor and terrifying white blaster rifles. We're heading towards the rebel base, chugging through apparently knee-high orange sherbet. But we're not done with the Blue Stars yet, because the Blue Stars, I guess, have their own fandom now. Because people make custom-made figures based on the Blue Stars.
The Blue Stars.
We're not done with the Blue Stars yet, because the Blue Stars are now apparently canon. The entire listing before you click purchase. Our beloved Steve does do a fair amount of late night online shopping. And one night, Steve thought he was purchasing a 1/6 scale stormtrooper.
Be an artist.
Oh, touch that!
Yeah. Danger, baby, yeah. Grogu, close up!
Oops. There we go.
Neat. Did you ever think you'd see
that? Yeah. They actually have made one. Really surprised they haven't actually made like a stroller for people who have their baby right now.
He's got some mileage.
Yeah.
So,
Susan, did you see
we're going to tell a story about this. Actually, I'm going to tell two stories about this.
Oh, this is my favorite, too.
Because we found out. Okay, so this cast was worn by Paul Weston, who is a stunt player. And he broke his leg during Return of the Jedi, out in the deserts of Yuma while they were filming the Sarlacc scenes. So we found out like 4 or so years ago, after Mr. Weston's family came and paid a visit, that we had been telling the wrong story.
Oh.
Of how he broke his leg. So I'm going to tell you both, because why the heck not? And then, if I can get a reach over you, if you don't mind. Thank you. His family came by and brought some more photos, which is very kind of him. Here's him with his broken leg and Carrie Fisher. And then they brought Paul Weston back in Rogue One as one of the scientists that were later gunned down.
Didn't know this in Rogue One, huh?
Yeah, that was really cool.
Stuntman that broke his leg and here's his cast.
So the story we were telling, which ended up being incorrect, was that Mr. Weston was in the costume of the first non-human character that fell into the Sarlacc. I forget the name of the species. And that falls and hits the crash pad, no problem. Director says, let's do another take. Between take one and two, someone kicked a coil of rope. He got his foot caught in it. And he fell against the side of the skiff, and that's how he broke his leg. No, we were wrong. That is incorrect. The correct story is Paul Weston was also Harrison Ford's stunt double for years. So he's been Han Solo, he's been Indiana Jones, etc., etc. So the moment there was a wide shot where Han is holding on to Lando, and it's the moment where Han's still kind of blind and is trying to shoot the tongue tickle thing, whatever, that's gonna try to pull Lando in, and Lando's saying him higher. So what happened was the cable that was supporting them broke. So the Lando stunt player goes to grab the cable, and apparently shreds his hand a bit. And then Paul Weston just falls past the Lando stunt player, hits the crash pad, Lando stunt player lands on his leg.
Aye.
And that's how he broke his
leg.
Snap. But it's the signatures on the cast that, I guess, are the high points?
Yeah.
Yep.
So, such as towards the bottom here, we've got What and Give Up Show Business, Your Loving Nurse Day Shift, Carrie Fisher. Stuart Freeborn, the creature designer and the guy who designed Yoda. Hope your next break's a good one. Kenny Baker, whose background is theater and British music hall, break a leg. At the top, there's a scoreboard. Sarlacc 1, Stuntmen 5, Mark Hamill. And then Robert Watson, associate producer, wrote, "Don't lose your sense of Yuma."
Yuma, Arizona.
That's right.
Missing body parts.
Yeah, it is. There's a lot of really cool ones in there.
What's in the tube?
Count Dooku's head and his hand.
Oh, the lightsaber.
Yeah, so the tube is from a...
Oh my god.
Yeah, exactly.
This collection of BB-8 is incredible.
Yeah, we kind of leaned in heavy on BB-8.
Oh my god.
I think it's the people who made a lot of BB-8. He's got it.
Everything. Well, every single...
They leaned in first. Yeah. So they had to make all this.
Yeah, it's BB-8 waters, coloring books, pencils, barbecue sauce, Band-Aids, vitamins.
Is he as big as a...
watches, toys, Pez.
I think the older
water bottles. Have you ever seen a bigger collection of BB-8?
So
plush toys. This is definitely updated.
Well, I just sold my thing like this.
This is a display of a Star Wars kids' bedroom in the 70s, 80s. Bunk bed. Everything toy.
Water and freeze it, and then I guess you carry it to the beach. But we had one,
including the R2D2 model kit in progress.
Joseph could pick one up, and even without it being loaded up with water, it's heavy. It has wheels, so you got a stagehand push it on. But I have one stipulation. And that is, you need to return it to me however you trick it out. So they have the George segment, they roll R2 Mr. T2 out there, have it make beep, boop, beep sounds, and the super title reads, "I Pity the Sith." they
make him laugh?
They got a smirk out of them. So I'm just guessing high fives were shared all around. And then the larger Legos came to us from the demise of FAO Schwartz. I did mention items that got dropped on us by Nissan. Mm-hmm. So the Executioner Trooper and the control panel, I guess were used in a commercial. Mm-hmm. And then I came here to do some other volunteer work one day. There was a huge crate in the garage, and we opened it up, and that dude's standing there staring at us. I want to tell a story about this, because this is a lesson for everyone. So, now, as to, did they make different sizes?
Like, some guys' butts might be bigger than other guys' butts, you know what I'm saying? Or some guys' thighs might be really skinny, so unlike models
or the car
where they're all the damn same size, because all the sample sizes are
right.
Four,
right.
They do the same thing with the stormtroopers. They just found guys that were basically with
three. Right. So I missed it. Pre-Boba Fett.
Yeah, I got a whole story about that.
This whole table is Cooper.
So everything in there is made from the original molds. Even the larger stuff, because they had different scales.
Oh, the Star Destroyer?
So the blaster towers, most of those were screen used. The three-dimensional ones were foreground towers, and the ones on the top right were with like two-sided but with lines painted on them were background towers.
Can you go to another rank?
Wow, I didn't know that. That's really cool.
Any exhaust ports there?
Yeah, we got something close, but not like the exhaust port. We have like tertiary exhaust.
Biscuit foam.
Some of them are made from the original molds. I think the ones that are like primer colored, like rust primer colored.
Thank you for telling me.
Nice.
I mean, like, I mean, with this, you're gonna want to get the lens up close, because that's gonna give, in my opinion, that's gonna give you the more rewarding images.
So, tell me what that is.
Which one is?
The middle.
The Japanese.
Samurai?
Yeah, the samurai. Is that sort of
the Japanese?
Tell me the story about the samurai.
Lucasfilm Animation in Singapore.
Oh, okay.
So they've got the office building. It's like a giant glass sand crawler.
Oh,
and
wow.
One of these is there.
Okay.
Yeah. So if you're doing, because we'll have guests that will do the Yoda statue hunt.
Yeah.
So, of course, you can get to this one. The one at Summit's a little more difficult to get to, but Imagination Park and Lucasfilm are easy ones to get to. So, but that just may be a childhood fear coming to the front. We don't need to worry about that. And whoever is the therapist, I'll give you $10 at the end for your time. Thank you. When Steve was talking about the Swarovski R2... Oh, that was another tour. Sorry. We got a new one. I'm sorry. I just noticed the Grogu. I didn't even notice it last tour. Got a Grogu. Oh, cool. All right, Steve. Groovy. Anyway. And this... bounty hunter Boba Fett that's got a missile firing out of his backpack.
Oh, yeah, cool.
And then the address, and then the, you know, 6 proof of purchase plus 695 S&H. So between, by the new character Boba Fett, between there and the release, some kid choked on a missile from a Cylon Raider. Which instituted the choke tube test. If it could fit into the choke tube, it was a no-go. So, through both iterations of the prototype, the J slot and the L slot, it still fit inside the choke tube. So what we got in the mail was Boba Fett and a note that said, due to safety concerns, the missile's been sonically welded in. If you are dissatisfied, you can exchange it for another figure of your choice. I'm guessing at least one of y'all would like your photo taken in this hallway. I'm just guessing.
Just
am I correct?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Probably.
All right, so you don't need to see any identification. So, a few things.
First drawings were off dead for Star Wars.
And then, so the second item we couldn't fit in the original museum is that big old Darth Vader head at the end. I'm going to talk about in a minute after I finish talking about this painting. Trust me on this. So.
Wow. I'm an old guy.
But OG. Young at heart. Young at heart.
Very young at heart. The very first thing I bought, I saw at a Spencer's Gifts.
Okay.
Yeah. And it was a necklace, but it was a R2 and separately a 3PO, and they had moving parts on them. And that's the first time. It was before the action figures came out, and there had just been cardboard puzzles and things like that, and that didn't really impress me. I went back and bought all of those afterwards. But that was the very first items that I bought.
Do you still have that necklace?
Oh, yeah.
Is it in the collection? Did we miss it?
I think the question is, have you ever thrown anything away?
That's a different question.
No, I was like, wanting to know what like item number one was.
Did I ever throw anything away? I've thrown away some spoiled things, like...
The celery that was in the celery bag.
No. Star Wars celery?
Yeah.
Star Wars celery, pineapples, bananas.
There's cookies or things.
How does insurance...
The Rose Parade pieces. Yeah, we have pieces, other pieces from the Rose Parade floats beyond those two statues. And some of them were made with gummy type things, like dried apricots.
Flowers on it?
Those are seeds, aren't they? Those are probably
seeds. Yeah, they're seeds, cinnamon, and as long as they're something that had been alive or is alive. So those are poppy seeds, cinnamon,
that's cool.
Green.
I didn't realize that.
Things like that.
How does insurance, what do you guys do for insurance?
Great Star Wars question.
And Anne and our social media person, Concetta, and Tracy, our lead on the volunteers, found it up in the loft when we were cleaning up for one of our online galas. And then I, for years, said,
and I'm looking for this particular Hungarian poster. I have the main Hungarian posters for all three of the original movies, but I'm looking for this really rare one. I think there are only like three known to exist. And one day Anne says, is it anything like this one? And there it is.
There it is.
Again, I have no recollection of getting that.
Same thing with the ADAT poster you just got. He said, Anne, come on, put this. I got it at an auction. It's the first time I ever did the auction. Yeah, it's really cool. Next day,
you already had it.
And found
this is crazy. They're just letting us play these games?
Yeah.
There's 27 helmets up here. Episode 3, film used chair. Can't remember what scene, but it was towards the end of the film. We got Star Wars racer. This is pretty old. Okay, bye, Rancho Obi-Wan. Love you.